So let's find out a bit more about types. Now, there is a keyword called type of, and let's do that. Let's see what the type of 3 is. The line of code executes, the cell there executes, and we see it as a 64-bit integer, a 64-bit integer. Now, let's do type of 3.0. That'll indicate something else that is a floating point, a 64-bit floating point. Let's carry on. Let's look at something else. What is the type of pi we had here in our example? And we see that's a math construct, pi, a constructor with one method. So that's a bit odd, but we certainly will get into that. The same is going to go for something like a fraction here. Let's do that. Type of 3 over 4. And remember, we hold down the shift key and hit to return on a Mac, or hold down the shift key and hit the enter key on Windows and Linux. And we see it says rational there of type integer 64, also constructor with a one method. Let's carry on. What about values such as this? Type of, now we are going to get to strings anytime you write some text that has got to go into quotation marks, and it's got to be double quotation marks in Julia. Julia makes use of double quotation marks. So if we just typed in the word Julia there, and we see that is an ASCII string, a constructor with two methods. So you can play around with this, type in all sorts of things you want, all sorts of values, and Julia will tell you what type that is. Now, before we sign off, I want to tell you about supertypes and subtypes. I mentioned that this is a hierarchical system, and we can find out what a type's parent is and what its children are. So let's look at float 64. What is the supertype? What is the supertype of float 64? And for that we can write super, and we put float. Remember when we said 3.0, it said float 64, and we execute that, and we see its parent, called its supertype, is floating point. So that means floating point must have more than one child. So float 64 will just be one of the children. So let's look what the parent is of floating point then. And this is how you can play around so that you can learn more about the structure that's going on here. So let's say floating point, and we execute that, and we see, that's part of the real numbers. Let's see what the parent of real is, and we see that the parent of real is number. Let's see what the parent of number is. Number, and we see the parent of number is any. Now, any is as high as it gets. Any is like the old great 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 grandfather of all of the types in Julia. So from any it goes all the way down. So if you don't declare the type of objects that a variable will hold, it's going to default to any, and then as you execute the code, Julia will figure out what type of object this is, and it will put it into a bucket that holds that kind of object. And that bucket is actually just a space in memory. Now, just as we had the parents there, we can also very quickly look at all the children. So I can look at what subtypes we have here. So let's type in subtypes, and let's put in any. Now, of course, any is going to have quite a few, and it won't be able to list all of them here, but you can see these little dot 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 there. So it means it's just showing us the start and the end of this whole long list of children that any has. But let's look at number specifically, because number, we saw that any was the parent of number. So let's look at the children of number itself. So subtypes of number. Let's see what kind of children it has. We see it only has 4, complex, dual 4, dual and real. Let's look at the real, let's look at complex first of all. So subtypes, and let's look at complex. And we see, that just stands all on its own. So complex there stands on its own there as far as the bottom kind of this hierarchical tree is concerned. Let's look at real. Subtypes of real. Let's have a look at that. And we see we get fixed point, floating point, integers, and we see these others. Let's go down floating point. So let's say subtype of floating point. Floating point, see what I did there? I typed in FLOA and I hit the tab key and it shows me what it can do to finish that word off for me, code completion. And I just used my up and down arrow keys to the bottom one that selected. I hit tab, I hit enter or return, and that finishes the line off for me. And I see we get big floats, float 16s, float 60, 32s, and float 64. And let's look at integer then, as an example as well. Let's see the subtypes of integer. And we see we get big integer, boolean, char, that is, says that means character, a single character, A, B, C, signed and unsigned. So you can play around with this hierarchical tree and you can figure out quite a few things, how these types are put together.